now, the great department store is open. Helen Hayes, a customer. Burgess Meredith, a tight clerk. Anthony Ross, a floor walker. Several years ago, when I was 22, as a matter of fact, I got a job by hook and crook that was rather wonderful in that, apart from the $3 a day that I earned, I met without formalities of any kind a great many people who seemed in fine spirits and were very much able to convey to me some of their quality. I have tried in this little play, A Christmas Tie, to remember these people, and I hope that you find it enjoyable.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, my, there are so many different kinds, aren't there?
Yes, ma'am.
These, what are they?
These are special, 69 cents.
My.
Yes, ma'am.
And you've sold many, many, many ties over the years?
No, I just started this morning. In fact, you're my first customer.
Oh, that tie you're wearing.
New York tie, do you like it?
Well, isn't it just a little... Well,
distinguished?
Yes, it is rather, in a way.
Yes.
What color is it?
It used to be green. I think it's brown.
It doesn't look brown, more black.
Oh.
But then, of course, it isn't black either.
It's dirty, I'm afraid. But you cannot wash ties, you know.
No, they just don't launder, do they?
No, they certainly don't.
Here am I, so tired.
Oh.
And still such a lot of shopping to do. So very, very, very much.
Sit down.
Mm. Oh, thank you.
You have a lot of shopping. That means you must have a lot of money.
Oh, I have a small income.
You do?
A small annuity from my dear father. He was such a thoughtful man. Bessie, Bessie, Bessie. I can still hear him saying, you must always, always, always think, my child. Think, think, think.
Think?
Yes. Oh, a great man. In many ways, but mainly in land, real estate. Think, think, think. He liked to say things three times.
He did?
Yes. After my dear mother died, I was only 11 then. And then there were only the two of us, my father and myself.
Where is he?
On. He passed on. I have been lost without him.
You didn't get married?
Bows, 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 one after the other. Never one I'd have.
Why not?
I wonder, were they as bad as all that?
I don't know, were they?
Well, there it is. They got married and I didn't. Mm-hmm. Well, you've been most kind, young man.
No.
Oh, courtesy is such a rare thing. It always touches me deeply. Courtesy, 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 dear boy.
What else did your father say?
Many things. But best of all, think, think, think.
Think? Why did he keep saying that?
I never was very good at it. Well, certainly not an expert. Mm-hmm. Well, it's been most charming chatting with
charming
you, young man.
With you, too. Thank you. Goodbye.
There. Is that a New York tie, too?
It's a Pasadena tie. This...
Pasadena? I had no idea. Pasadena, a city like that. Making ties. Oh, and is that a Pasadena tie, too?
Yeah. This is a Santa Barbara tie.
Santa Barbara.
They make ties there, too?
Perhaps they make them everywhere.
I guess they do.
And then they send them all to this store.
Yes. Yeah.
Where is that one from?
What is this? Reno tie.
Reno? Where they get married? I mean divorced.
Yes, I guess so.
New York, Pasadena, Santa Barbara, Reno. Now, that one there wouldn't be from Palo Alto, would it? I have several friends in Palo Alto. I would like to write to them and tell them that I'd seen a tie from their city.
I can't... Oh, a Mexican tie.
A tie from Mexico. Oh, and that one wouldn't be from Paris, would it? It looks so nice. Oh, I love France. Thank you.
Your name, please?
Avon Horsley, Jr.
How long have you been employed at the Emporium?
About, 26 minutes.
What experience have you had in merchandising?
Well, I really must go. Goodbye, young man.
Goodbye.
And you, too. Goodbye.
One moment, madam. Please. Mr. Horsley.
Sir.
Look about you.
Yes.
Do you notice anything?
Yes, sir.
What do you notice?
Ties.
Mm. What do you notice about them?
The colors, the designs, the dots, and all the rest of it, sir.
Do you notice any of the ties missing?
Missing?
Yes. Ties that were here a moment ago, no longer here. Do you notice that?
Well, it's been most charming.
Now, one moment. That...
But I simply must get about my shopping.
Shopping?
Oh, yes.
In a moment, then. Mr. Horsley.
Sir.
The 69 cent tray.
Yes.
Wasn't it full of ties a moment ago?
Yes, sir.
Mm. Where are they now?
I don't know, sir.
How many ties have you sold this morning?
None.
Then the ties that were in the tray you didn't sell?
No, sir.
Did you put them away somewhere?
Would you excuse me, sir? Would you like to sit down again?
Oh, thank you.
You, what did you say?
I said, did you put them away somewhere?
No.
All right, then, Mr. Horsley. Where are the ties?
I don't know.
Excuse me. Mr. Horsley.
What? Sir.
Who hired you?
The employment department.
Mm. You took the merchandising course?
Yes, sir. All of yesterday afternoon.
This lady is a friend of yours?
Well, she just came a moment ago.
Is that your mother, your aunt, your landlady?
No.
You never saw her before until she came here a moment ago?
No, sir.
Yes, you've been talking together, have you?
Yes, sir.
Mm. While you were talking?
Yes, sir.
You didn't notice anything?
Well, I noticed her.
What did you notice?
Just her.
Did she buy a tie?
No, sir.
Two ties?
No, sir.
Ten?
No, sir.
20?
No, sir.
33?
No, sir.
And yet, Mr. Horsley, the 69 cent ties that were in the tray are all gone.
Yes, sir.
Hmm. They didn't get up and go by themselves, did they?
Oh, I didn't see them do that, sir.
Hmm. You got through high school?
It's required. The employment department gives no one a job that hasn't completed high school. But I've been 2 years at college so far, too.
The Barber College?
No, that's SF.
SF?
University of San Francisco.
You are majoring in?
Psychology.
Psychology?
Yes.
Mr. Horsley.
Oh. Sir.
But you don't know how the ties disappeared?
No, no.
Now, Mr. Horsley, were the ties on the tray when the lady arrived?
Ah, yes.
Hmm. Did any while the lady was here visiting with you, nobody else arrived?
No, sir.
No. This would suggest what?
Uh-huh. I don't know.
You are majoring in psychology.
Yes, but that has to do with human personality, not ties.
This lady, she's human, isn't she?
Yes, sir.
Hmm. You are too, aren't
you?
Yes,
sir.
All right. Mr. Horsley, let's begin all over.
Oh,
now. The ties were on the tray when you came to work this morning.
Yes, sir.
They were on the tray when this lady arrived.
Yes, sir.
Nobody else arrived while the lady visited with you.
No, sir.
The ties are no longer on the tray.
No, sir.
You didn't move them from the tray to the shelves behind you or to the showcases.
No, sir.
Where are the ties, Mr. Horsley?
I don't know.
Where do you think they might be?
Bessie, did you happen to notice what happened to those ties, Bessie?
Of course. I have them all. I want to buy them.
Hmm? Oh, you do?
Courtesy, courtesy, courtesy. There is no substitute for courtesy. But I want more. That tie over there. Yes. Now, where is that from?
Just a moment.
The Baltimore tie.
You have one moment, please.
Both of you.
Your name, madam.
Bessie.
That's so I gather. Bessie what?
Bessie Arlington. I am the daughter and only child of Oliver Arlington and his bride, Elizabeth Aylesworth. As a young woman, my mother listed among her friends George Sterling, the great San Francisco poet. Although, as things turned out, she married my father, and dear George, gentle George, well, his poems will certainly never die. My cool gray city of love, Ambrose Bierce was his teacher. His father would be more accurate. You must read his poems sometime. They will exalt your soul.
No doubt. In the meantime, madam, you wish to buy these ties, is that it?
Of course.
Yes, 33 ties at 69 cents each. You wish to buy?
And more, too, perhaps.
These packages, what? These are purchases you made in the store?
No.
I didn't think so. The wrappings aren't familiar. What are these packages, madam?
Gifts.
Oh, gifts you bought?
Gift to me, from my father.
Is he in the store?
No. He, well, he passed on.
When?
Well, it's almost 20 years now.
And he gave you these gifts just before he passed on?
Oh, no, long before that. This one I remember he gave me on my 18th birthday. And this one, when they brought me home. I was about 25 then. Books, of course, but not poems. He had no feeling for them. I can't understand the blasted things he always says. This is the basic principles of logic. And this is how to think clearly. I've read them for years, but I never understood them. Though I pretended to my father that I did. And then, when he passed on, I wrapped them again, exactly as they were when he gave them to me. And where I go, they go. For he was a practical man. Oh, I remember so well his patient instructions when they brought me home.
Brought you home from where?
Oh, I was ill for quite some time. I was engaged to a rather wonderful but strange man. He had us believe that he was in business, but my father discovered that, well, he wasn't. Not really. I fell ill at that time.
He wasn't in business?
Not as my father understood the word.
Well, what did he do?
He sold things in the streets, out of satchels.
Potato peelers, mending fluids, medicine.
Ties. Inexpensive ties. My father was astonished, absolutely flabbergasted.
He was?
Yes, he forbade me ever to see him again.
He did?
Yes. That was, I think, when I fell ill. Oh, yes, I went on several business trips with my father. I never did see him again, except from my father's car. Oh. On the street corner.
Selling ties.
Yes.
I see, madam.
He was a handsome man. Rather like him.
Him?
Rather a lot like him.
Oh, I see. But you never spoke to the man again?
No, that's when I went on these business trips with my father. I was ill most of the time, and then my father decided that it would be best if I were taken care of by some people in Palo Alto who understand such things.
Oh, I see. You were there a short while, a month, perhaps.
3 years, I think.
Miss Arlington,
I was standing over there a moment ago, and I couldn't help...
I wanted many ties.
Yes, I understand.
I thought how fine it would be if I saw him again on the street and gave him all the ties. My fiancé, I mean.
I see.
I think it was because he resembled him so much.
I see.
I had had for such a long time such a vision of our life together that when I saw all these ties...
Yes, I can imagine, Miss Arlington. Miss Arlington, your address, please.
It's still the same.
But I don't know what it is.
I live alone in the house my father left me, 137 Eden Lane. Yes.
You have an account at the Emporium?
Oh, I have accounts at all the stores.
You wish to charge these ties? Hmm?
Yes, please.
You wish them sent?
No, I wish to take them.
Well, you wish to have them wrapped, of course.
No. Oh, you are a kind young man, and I'm tired. But I do want to take my ties and go.
Now, Miss Arlington, I'll only be a moment. Excuse me. Accounts. Accounts? Miss Bessie Arlington, 137 Eden Lane. Yes, this is Floor Walker Wallinghead speaking. I'll hold on.
Do you find me strange, young man?
Oh, no, not really. See, I'm strange myself, I guess.
Yes. That tie, it's so old, you can keep on wearing it.
Well, I don't bother much about clothes.
Do you come from a large family?
Oh, no, there's just two younger brothers and myself. But you know, I hope to have a large family of my own someday.
Many boys and many girls.
Yes. Yes, I see. Thank you very much. No, nothing at all. Employment department, please.
I believe in families, especially big ones.
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps that's because my own was such a small one. An only child is a lonely child, I always say. But I have friends, of course, all around. And they are kind, terribly kind. And they are so understanding. Hardly a day goes by that somebody doesn't understand me. I mean, deeply.
Mm-hmm.
I do appreciate it. It's almost like being a member of a big family. You do understand me, don't you?
Oh, a little, I guess.
And I mean you did before, too, when I first came up.
I think so.
Employment department. Floor Walker Wallinghead speaking. A holiday employee, Avon Horsley, began work this morning. Will you read his card to me, please?
And you like your new job?
Oh, yes.
But still you have no feeling for ties.
No, not really. I only wear one at a time, you know, this.
Will you allow me to make you a present of a new one?
Oh, no.
I'd like to. Now you must let me pick it out, and then you must put it on before I leave,
no,
so I can see it.
No, I couldn't do that. You couldn't.
Oh, you must.
No.
Courtesy. I am devoted to courtesy, and you are too. Now, I must pick an exceptionally nice one. One that will catch the eye of a pretty girl.
Well, I'm afraid it'll take more than a new tie to fix me up.
This one?
Hmm?
It's yours.
Ah, thank you very much.
Bessie.
Don't forget
I'm Bessie.
Thank you, Bessie, very much.
You won't forget me, will you?
I certainly won't.
Now, put the tie on so I can see it.
Now? All right. I'm afraid, though, that this won't make much difference. This is a very nice tie, and of course it's brand new, but I'm just afraid it won't make much difference. You know, I hope I'm never hung for some wild opinion I may have someday.
You wouldn't forfeit your life for something you believe.
No. I might be mistaken. Well, do I look okay?
Oh, you do. You look just like him now. He liked bright ties.
Yes.
Oh, if I were a young girl again, I'd know what I'd do.
Yes. Yes, I see. Thank you very much. No. Everything's in good order.
Yeah, Miss Arlington just gave me a brand new tie.
You're very kind, Miss Arlington. Looks very good on you, Mr. Horsley.
Well, I never thought ties meant very much. I'll throw the old one away.
Oh, no, that's the one I want wrapped, and that's the only one. The others I'll take as they are.
A gift package?
Yes, if I may.
The special gift box and paper and wrapping, Mr. Horsley. Now, madam, let me see if I can help. Miss Bessie Arlington, 137 Eden Lane. Charge. Take. All of them, Miss Arlington?
Yes, please.
33 ties.
Don't forget the one he's wearing.
Oh, yes. 34 ties. There we are, Miss Arlington. You sure you want to take them just as they are?
Yes, please. May I? Now?
Yes, Miss Arlington.
Oh, they are beautiful. Yes. And so many of them.
I know. Now, here is.
Thank you, dear boy.
Madam.
And you too. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Miss Arlington.
Goodbye, Miss Arlington.
Bessie.
Goodbye, Bessie.
She's quite a character around town, apparently. You know, I thought you were stupid. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's all right. You know, this job is only temporary, just for the Christmas vacation, but I do need the job badly.
The money?
Oh, yes, of course, I can always use the money for food. But what I'm really interested in is people.
Well. I'm sure you'll make out all right.
Well, I... Thank you, sir.
I want to buy a tie for my boyfriend.
What kind?
A Christmas tie, of course.
Yes, but from where?
From where?
Yes, from where? We have all kinds of ties, girls. From Mexico, Baltimore, Pasadena, Santa Barbara, Reno, Palo Alto, Cincinnati, Azusa, and all points...